Welcome to a tutorial on how to enter salaries into Enston Ledger. All you'll need to follow along with me is a web browser and an Enston Ledger account. The goal of this video is to show you how to post salaries and wages into Enston Ledger using journal entries. That said, let's dive right into the demonstration. For the purpose of this demonstration, let us assume that ABC Private Limited has an employee named John with a basic salary of 2,000 Singapore dollars. Let's further assume that his salary is subject to CPF contribution at a rate of 20% for the employee and 17% for the employer. Also, that he contributes 50 cents to the Chinese Development Assistance Council, which is a non-profit self-help group for the Chinese community. To post all those into Enston Ledger, go over to the left-hand side of the page and click on Journal menu. Select Journal Entry submenu from the drop-down menu to open the page. Once the page is opened, on the right side of the screen, proceed to click the Create button on the right-hand side. Enston Ledger redirects you to the Create Journal Entry page, where you can enter the necessary details. Now, with this page open, let us proceed to enter the double entries in two steps. Ideally, the double entries for the first step will be posted at the end of the month, when John's net pay is deposited into his account. Using the net pay of 1,599.50 Singapore dollars as an example, the debit side of the journal entry would be wages and salaries staffs, and the credit side would be the bank from which the net pay is paid out. For the employee CPF portion, the debit side would be wages and salaries staffs of 400 Singapore dollars. For the employer CPF portion, the debit side would be employer CPF staffs of 340 Singapore dollars. For the CDAC contribution, the debit side would be CDAC of 50 cents. Also, let us assume that John's pay is also subject to skill development levy of 5 Singapore dollars. The last debit entry would be SDL of 5 Singapore dollars. The credit side of the above four debit entries would be CPF payable of 745.50 Singapore dollars. Once this is done, click the Create button. In the event that John is a director, you should choose Wages and Salaries Director and Employer CPF Director's account codes, instead of wages and salaries staffs and employer CPF staffs. Let's verify the journal entries in the respective reports. Firstly, you can see in the profit and loss report that wages and salaries staffs expense is 1,999.50 Singapore dollars. Employer CPF staffs expense is 340 Singapore dollars. CDAC expense is 50 cents, while SDL expense is 5 Singapore dollars. Next, you can see that the balance sheet shows the CPF payable balance of 745.50 Singapore dollars. Over here, in general ledger account transactions, you can also see that the above entries have been posted accordingly. With the verification done, we can proceed to the second step. Here, the CPF contribution is paid out from the company's bank. Double entries for this leg of the transaction are pretty straightforward. With $745.50 debited to the CPF payable account and the same amount of $745.50 credited to UOB Bank. As usual, we can verify this in the respective reports. Over here in Balance Sheet Report, you can see that the CPF payable account is zero and UOB bank balance is reduced by the amount of $745.50. Let's just take a look at the account transactions report to see the double entries. Here, you can verify that the double entries have been posted with a debit to CPF payable account and a credit to the bank account. This should give you a good foundation on how to enter salaries and wages in Enston Ledger. Feel free to check out the other tutorials. See you next time.